very present. And right now I'm changing very important aspects of my life, so I'm definitely starting to understand some aspects about money.
Dominique and a vehicle.
I'm Brittany, and it's a resource, an unlimited resource.
Yeah. I'm Antonella, and I want to learn that it's an energy. I want to learn that.
I'm Elizabeth, and I would say it's just a piece of paper.
It's a paper. I need. Okay, so we all have different opinions on life, right? And it's always no right or wrong about it, you know? But money is definitely energy. It's positive energy. It's love energy, right? It's currency. So it must flow. It must flow. It's currency. It has an ebb and a flow. It goes and it comes, right? But we can't too attach to when it goes, because it always comes. It's us, right? And so what I really, really am passionate about doing is making the people see the abundance that's within us, right? Because let's just face it, in this day and age, repeating the same generational wealth cycles. We got student loans, right? These nasty student loans. You get to college and they have to pay all of this debt, right? Maybe your parents have been through the same thing. Maybe their parents have been through the same thing. So it's this continuous cycle of not really having the education or the skills to be able to just, you know, generate wealth on our time, right? Nobody really taught us how to grow money. They taught us to go to school. You better get in a good college and make good grades, because you don't want to get kicked out. You know, get married, have kids, repeat the cycle. Repeat the cycle. Repeat the cycle. Right? But to be the change that we want to see, it starts with us. To be the change for our generation and our generation to come, for our kids and our kids' kids, it starts with the awareness right now, in this very now moment. And so, I've been traveling around now for about 4 or 5 years, just teaching financial education, financial literacy, but it hasn't always been like this at all. Like, I, you know, grew up in a small town of Fayetteville, North Carolina. My father was in the military, my mom was as well, but when they split up, things went haywire. You know, Christmas for me was just like playing with the toys for a little bit and then having to take it to the pawn shop because we need to pay bills. You know, so that's scarring on a child. What happens to us at a child level, at a seed? Money is like, it's like a plant. You have to grow with anything in life, right? So, you know, scarring a child like that at a young age has an effect right now. Most of us have money blockages. We repel money instead of bringing in money. Because deep from the core, starting from a child age, right? So I like to do examples. I like to be visual. Because we can talk. But one thing for sure is numbers never lie. I can go up here and preach to the choir, but one thing is not going to lie, it's numbers, right? And that's what set me off on this path to make sure that I free myself, not only myself, my community. So, and these are just some statistic numbers, right? So let's just say the average person is going to work 9 to 5, right? The average, you know, sometimes we go to 8 to 4, different times, right? We're just going to use 9 to 5. That's about 7 hours. Right, for that day. Right?
Yep.
We all still alive?
Yeah. 8 hours.
I know these tops, and you're like, but I want to make it fun for you. I want you to see this, right? So, 9 to 5 for 7 hours. So, put 7 hours. Right? And time.
What?
That's 8 hours.
8 hours.
Oh, my bad. Numbers never lie. You see that?
You just want to know if you pay attention, right?
Yeah, I like that. Thank you. So, time, it's not even about the money, it's about the time. Time you can never get back. Those soccer games you miss, those years of your kids growing up, you can't get that back. That money goes and comes, right? So we want to preserve our time. Our time is our valuable asset. What we invest our time to is very important. What are we doing all day? How many hours are we on Facebook? How many hours are we watching Netflix? These are things that we have to ask ourselves, what is our children doing? How long are they playing video games? What are they learning from these video games? So we have to ask ourselves as a community as well. So 8 hours. Now let's just hypothetically say you're doing that for $10 an hour. I know some people get 15, some people get 12, some people get less than 10. We're just using this for example right now. So that's basically $80 in 1 hour. Just it's about, right? If you're working 8 hours times $10, is about $80 for that one day, right?
So 8 hours. That would be nice in Mexico.
Yeah. Okay.
Right.
Yeah.
See, you know, and this is just, like I said,
that's one of the problems.
This is just a small scale. But
situation problem, like local. It's a local problem. Most people.
Everyone around the world. So what I'm really trying to get you to see is that for 8 hours of your life is being to build somebody else's generation. You got to think about it. You're working at a deli, right? You're going to the deli day in, day out, getting tired. You really don't want to go there. You don't even like the people you work with, right? And so you're doing it to go build up Bob's bakery. Bob's going to pass that bakery on to his kids. He's going to teach them how to do it. But what are we doing? What are we leaving for our children? What kind of legacy are we leaving for our kids? What talents and gifts can we do to make abundance for ourselves? Because whatever you're passionate about or whatever you have learned, you should earn from it. If you look at the word learn, it has to learn. Right? You learn how to play the guitar. You get down out there on the corner, you play the guitar a little bit, you might pay a light bill or something. I don't know. I'm just saying. It's something you learn. Why not use that skill set? So I was sitting in my office. I added up the amount of hours that I had to go to work. I added up the amount of hours of when I got home, how long I had personal time, you know, personal time. Getting home, cooking, and getting ready for the next day. Personal time, right? And then I added how many hours I slept. Because remember, time is very valuable. And so as I sat at that desk, my working life and my sleeping life trumped my dinner life. Some of you guys have kids. I don't have kids, so I don't really even know the full effect of having kids, having to nurse them. You got husbands, you got wives, you got to deal with them. When do you have time for you? When do you have time to breathe? When do you have time to get and write your poetry? Play the piano. Just lay down and massage yourself. Love yourself. Touch yourself. You know? When do we have time for that? And so, part of my K3 campaign, My Life Financial Liberation, is about liberating yourself, taking the bondage and the shackles that we have on ourselves. Because it's up to us. We have the power. We have to let go and let God.
Yes.
God, Jesus, Allah, whoever you may call the force. I don't think it's really complaining about a name, but you get what I'm saying, right? You know, let go and trust, right? And so now what I've been doing, one of my services that I've been offering is learning how to trade currency. Is anybody familiar with Bitcoin?
Yeah, for traveling, huh?
Traveling?
For traveling, Bitcoin is not...
It's but just like a currency. It's
okay.
Worldwide, right? Mm-hmm. So you heard a little bit about it, right? Mm-hmm.
It's a cryptocurrency, and it's linked to blockchain.
Yes.
There are miners, and I don't know what, there are miners who are just kind of producing the online money, and... That's pretty much what I know.
Okay. I like it. So yes, cryptocurrency... Bitcoin is like the brain, it's the head, the other cryptocurrencies are our babies, right? And so cryptocurrency is just a form of exchange. We agree to say that this piece of paper that can be printed out within matters of seconds is money. We fight each other, we kill each other over a piece of paper. We divide ourselves over a piece of paper. Piece of paper, right? And so cryptocurrency is just another form of exchange. So let me ask you this. If anybody can go back and get Bitcoin at $1, because you know it went up to 20. Now, remember, money's energy, ebb and flow. Goes up, goes down. Just because it went down, y'all don't think it's about to jump back up? So if you could go back and get Bitcoin for $1 today, would you do it? Because it's worth about $7,000 a day. Anybody go back and get a Bitcoin for $1
today? Yes.
I mean, that's a no-brainer, right? If you're spending $1 and you're about to get $7,000, I mean, come on now, right? So it's about timing. And so we're often going to teach you how to trade Forex market, right? Forex market, what is that, right? Foreign exchange market. Here in Mexico, most of us, some of us, got to take our American money, or we take our pesos, and we do that exchange, right? And depending on the American dollar rate, a lot of times you exchange that peso, you might be balling. You might have a little bit more. 20 American dollars might be like $50, like $50 peso, like you might literally fall. And that's what it is. When I went to Belize, 20 American dollars was 40 Belizean dollars. So I had a little advantage. That is the forex market, is the exchange from one currency to another currency. That's all it is. And so what I do is I teach people how to catch money from the forex market.
Works. We also have one more thing. We also have tools to
help you learn and earn the market at the same time. Let me ask you an honest question. What was your worst subject in school? Like you just, it was not your thing. Math, like, okay. So let me ask you this. Did you have somebody in math that you would cheat on? Like you knew that they was going to pass that homework and pass that test so you kind of copy off of it. This is for real.
Actually, it was a very bad subject, but it was a teacher's side. Once my friend, before the exam, she showed me everything, and I was really bad at this matter. Uh-huh. And she showed me everything, and I had 100 points out of 100 in the test. I was like the best of the class, and the teacher, she couldn't believe it.
Just like that, right? You would, so you basically take
the test. Interesting.
So why not take results from expo trainers? Like you took the results from the quiz in class, you already knew they was gonna make an A or a B on that test. You knew you wasn't, but you knew they was, so you put your trust into that, right? It's the same thing with the products and the services that we have. You can learn while you earn by basically me studying it already. Of course, I'm not an expert yet, okay? But basically, let's just say I've been mastering this for 20 years now, and I'm in this, right? I'm basically saying, here you go, just type into your phone, come back in about an hour, you're going to be in profit. That's basically what it is. That's literally what it is in a nutshell. Showing people how to do this every day. If you can make $100 a day for 7 days just because you're at your house, I feel like, okay, so the big people that are in this market are banks, government officials, hedge funders, and speculators, and us real estate retailers, right? So us as a people, we have the advantage to bring this market, bring this currency back into our hands, because the banks are doing it. Right? And get some more so right now, even if you're going to trade or not, if you have money in your bank is trading your money. Why do you think you get all these fees and all these expenses? You can't just pull your money out when you want to. It's not even your money. It's not even tangible. You don't even have the house in your money. You know? You can't even get to it when you want to because you got ATM money. You can only pull this amount out. If you go pull your money out, how are they going to trade it on the foreign market? How they gonna do that? And so to cover that, the forex market is really us, it's emotion. When the moon comes, it affects the planet. So some people, like you may feel like the Japanese dollar and the US dollar is gonna go in the box. You might strongly feel that from your analysis. I might feel like it's going in the sale, you know? If you choose to buy and I don't get the sale, I just don't get it. How it is, you know, competitive or we're kind of just predicting the current that makes sense. My analogy, my like patterns. Because what it does today, it does throughout the day. You know what I mean? Did that make sense?
How many times a day do you have to check the market?
Well, what you do is you stick to one pair. There's so many different pairs. It's like dating somebody. You want to know everything about it. What time do you like to do this? How do you feel when this time comes around? So you're kind of getting into your own flow. There's certain times that the market moves faster, like during the London session, which is like 2:00 in the morning all the way up to 12 p.m. So you would choose a time where you would want to maybe just do like an hour and just look at it, you know? And by using the products that we have, you really don't have to look much. Just put it in your phone and go live your life. Because the trade is going to close out for you. It's going to do everything for you once you put it in. So you're literally learning how to do this on autopilot, you know, systems. Save yourself time and money.
I can relate, but I understand you were talking about all the new cryptocurrency, right?
Uh-huh.
So I want to. I come from Denmark, and I have bought some years ago. But I would really like to know more about it because I really didn't understand it.
Okay.
So what are you doing? Are you teaching it, or what are you doing?
Yes, I am. So with cryptocurrency, you can either hold it. What that means is you hold on to it and wait for the value to go back up. Just like when you go to the store, you put this stuff on sale. You don't want to go to the store and get Bitcoin when it's high. You want to get Bitcoin when it's on sale, right? So you can hold it. Just hold it. You can trade it. That's what I do. That's what I teach you how to make it. Or you can also mine it. It takes up a lot of electricity and stuff. This is where the arena of, you know, finding innovative ways to sustain our planet. Maybe that could be something else to look into, like mining it in an eco-friendly way. But yeah, I teach how to trade it. I teach how to trade cryptocurrency on the Forex market, any type of currency.
So gold, yep, gold. Focus more into Forex or more into cryptocurrency, because they are like two different things, right? Connected,
connected because it's a currency, but we teach the education of cryptocurrency. So how it works, where it's from, the history, how it got started, blockchain. Like, we literally take you through a baby step of what it is, and then we teach you how to trade it on the Forex market. Because the Forex market is its own market on itself, just for currency and commodities.
On the Forex market, what would you recommend right now? Steel, silver, gold?
I love gold. I haven't been really getting into gold lately, but I've got into gold. I save in gold, and that's a conversation for another day, but I also show people how to save in gold. Like, literally open up a free gold savings account, get your gold sent to your house, or you can leave your gold in a vault, just like you leave your money in the bank. So you also can have the gold shipped to you in gold. So I do a lot of different things about financial, like I said, literacy, generational wealth. So I definitely give you my card. I definitely just wanted to share today the Forex, because it's literally something for my third week growing my account, like every day. Past profits don't equal future results, but I just want you to know how I made $346. I went to the gym at 5:30, put my trades in at 6 o'clock, I left the gym at 9:15, I had $346 just for placing two trades. I have this technique. I do 5 trades a day, Monday through Friday, to grow my account.
And how much money do you put in? What is the
You can grow your account from $50, you can grow your account from $20. I really show you how to do a plan. So you get this, like, if you do 50, we're gonna see how that looks in a month, or how that looks in a year, or how that looks in 6 months. So you can start with as low as $20, $10, $50.
But that's taking all the time. Right?
It will take a little bit more, but don't forget, it's about patience, you know, it's about learning the skill, you know? So it just depends on really how you wanna work it, to be honest.
How long are you
gonna stay? I'm gonna be here. I'm actually working on just, I have a lot, because we're in over 120 plus countries. So we're here in Mexico. I have educators in Mexico that speak Spanish as well. We're in Trinidad, we're in Germany, we're in France, we're all over the world. We have over 90,000 people in our organization learning this skill and traveling. I'll be here for about 2 months, and then I'll be in Miami doing some touring there, and then I'll be back. But definitely stay in touch. I can have a more intimate one-on-one. Just try to be respectful for everybody's time.
One more question. You said you also put up like the promedio. What is promedio in English?
Like the average,
the average family, like working, and, you know, whatever. So, how long did it take you to understand and to get a feeling for the money? Do you look at like the energy? How did you get this, you know, the smell? You know what I mean?
The curiosity to get
it. Like, the feeling to really say, okay, this is the right moment for this, and this is the right moment for this. How long did it take you?
You know, it really came back to what I said earlier, let go and let God. When you ask us, let go and let God, and trust. When you ask for something and it's presented, you ask for it. Why not take it? I asked for this. I asked the universe. I was like, look, I'm trying to acquire generational wealth. I want to teach my community, because it seems like money is a soft spot, a root. It's a struggle. And I'm like, no. It's our birthright to be abundant. To be in sin is a to be in lack is a sin. So I knew when somebody showed me this, I already knew it was for me. So I hopped on it. And because I just believed in myself, repetition. Remember when you were in school, you didn't understand that subject, but the more you went to class every day, you got that homework, you had to do the spelling words 5 times each, the definitions, write it out. Repetition, repetition, repetition. Subconscious mind, subconscious mind.
So Well, how much time did it take you?
I would say once I really got serious, I've been doing this since last year. I would say about 3 months to feel confident to get in my live account. Because we give you a demo account. A demo account is real live trading, but with fake money. So you can build up your confidence. You can see what you're doing. So you're really trading, but you don't have to put your money in there yet. You're just getting the hang of it. You know, you're seeing, you're like, oh, this product that she told me about is working. That's how I know it works. That's how I, where's my cell phone?
Here.
Oh, right now. Like, I gotta show you this. Like, that's how I know it works. I've been doing it every day. Next month, I'm going live. I'm doing my live account with live money, and I'm going to grow it. It's going to be a challenge. And I'm doing it with my community. We're all going to be making the money together. We're going to be going through it step by step every night. We're going to fill up our demo. So we're really doing this for the community worldwide.
So when are you teaching this?
After the class, you can just get up with me. I'm having one Wednesday, but you can get my contact information. It's going to be at 8 p.m. I haven't figured out the location yet. I normally do stuff at the Nest, but I love the next stuff too. So once again, this is about community. This is about making money and growing money together, you know? So I like to cook and make it more intimate and open the space up and give a little bit more information.
Wednesday?
Yes, Wednesday. Yeah. So I'm going to give you my card. Please contact me, and I'll let you know a location. And any type of, I do financial coaching. I help you check your budget, see what you have going in. By living my purpose. This is what I'm supposed to do. So the universe has already abundance and blessings for doing what I'm supposed to do. So, like I said, abundance is everything. I get blessed. And somebody, I can walk out here today and somebody like, here's a loaf of bread. And I'm like, oh my gosh, I need a loaf of bread. And I have to